All Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's post-royal projects and how they ended. Harry and Meghan have parted ways with Spotify less than 3 years into a multi-million dollar deal, but the partnership was just one of nine pursued during their post-royal lives. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have signed a spate of deals, starting a few months before the quit as working royals and with most signed by 2021. The plethora of partnerships will have given the couple multiple sources of income while paying off a $9.2 million mortgage on their Montecito mansion and with hefty costs for their private security detail and staff. Let's start with Disney. Meghan narrated the 2020 Disney nature movie Elephants, which followed African elephant Shani and her son Jomo on the journey from Kalahari Desert to the Zambezi River. Harry famously pitched Meghan as a voiceover actor directly to Disney CEO Bob Iger during a royal engagement at a premiere of The Lion King in July 2019. Meghan was approached by the filmmakers that autumn. Then talking about Apple Productions, Prince Harry agreed to make an Apple TV mental health documentary with Oprah Winfrey and her production company Apple before he formally quit royal duties. However, by the time May 2021 docuseries The Me You Can See dropped it and had been upstaged by Harry and Meghan's joint interview with Oprah, which aired on CBS 2 months earlier in March. In Oprah with Harry and Meghan, the Duchess accused an unnamed royal of having concerns and conversations about how dark her unborn child's skin might be. The interview sent shockwaves through British society and triggered a global conversation about racism, though Harry's later comments sucked some of the momentum out of the debate. The Me You Can See renewed the couple's criticisms of the royal family, palace and media in May 2021, a month after the death of Prince Philip, Harry's grandfather. And talking about Harry Walker Agency, Harry and Meghan signed with public speaking firm Harry Walker Agency, which also represented Barack and Michelle Obama in June 2020. The pair had in February that year done a speaking gig out of JP Morgan Alternative Investment Summit, and Meghan backed Black Lives Matter in a speech to graduating students of her old high school, Immaculate Heart, though it was never said whether either was part of the HWA deal. Then talking about Netflix, their biggest early project was a multi-million mega deal with Netflix signed in September 2020, which ultimately led to couple's December 2022 project, Harry and Meghan. The show sailed to the top of the Netflix chart, but critics from respected publications, including Variety, questioned whether they were simply rehearsing a story already told about a struggle with royal life. Later that month, they released the less talked about Live to Lead, which has inspired by Nelson Mandela and look at the stories of world leaders. Then talking about Spotify, Meghan and Harry signed with Spotify in December 2020 and initially made a festive special in which their son Prince Archie was a surprise guest. A full weekly podcast was promised for 2021, but no further content appeared until August 2022 when Meghan debuted Archdykes. The show initially sailed to the top of the Spotify charts with the first episode featuring an interview with Serena Williams, though later ones were less widely streamed. So guys, with that, we have come to an end of this episode. Thanks a lot for watching. Until next time, bye bye.